I never agree with any of the takes on the Hall of Fame. I think the whole system is broken, and I think that Daniel and I are exactly on the same page, and it blows my mind time and time again. Let's get upset here for a brief minute here. Can we fix the Hall of Fame? Is it possible?
I would hope so. And on Chad Brown, right? Like I said, I love the guy. He's one of the nicest guys in poker. If I look at his resume in poker, I don't think, you know, if you sort of just give everybody who's a nice, good guy, put him in the Hall of Fame, you're going to just have a really wide Hall of Fame that,
right,
you know, doesn't hold a lot of meaning. Like, he didn't post the kind of results that were, you know, at the top of his game. And there's a lot of other people who did first. So for me, I actually wrote out several times in blogs, like the changes I'd like to see to the Hall of Fame. I think the criteria should be a lot more clear, because currently the way that it's written, if you're a player, it shouldn't matter whatsoever if you were a nice person at all. You could be the biggest jerk who was arrested 15 times for, you know, drunk driving or whatever. But if your poker results said that, you know, you were worthy, that's what should have mattered. And it sort of got bastardized a little bit. I blame, frankly, and, you know, this is their choice. But, you know, when media had a vote, or when they have votes, they sort of vote for, like, oh, we love that guy, he's a big name. I'm like, but he's not good, you know, or like, he's not as good as some of the other players on this list. So I believe that the players that have played against all the players should be the ones making the decision. This year, the Hall of Fame vote goes to those that are in the Hall of Fame already.
Right.
And for this year, I believe, well, one of the things that I would fix is I would put a builder in every 3 years and not nominate him every other year. Because, you know, like, that way at least one builder goes in every 3 years. So then the Matt Savage types, along with, you know, Esai Scheinberg, who got all my votes this year. I think if there is a builder category, it kind of would be silly to not have Esai Scheinberg in that builder category. I've seen some of the takes, and I was really, like, eye-rolling. This Norman Chad dude was, like, shitting on Esai Scheinberg, right, who has been one of the most influential, in a positive way, you know, people in poker. And what a weird thing for Norman to do. He's nominated, but he's shitting on the other nominee. It's, like, such a bizarre f***ing take. Maybe because he only did that because I said, you know, I think Esai deserves it, right? So I do think Esai deserves it, no question about it. You know, people say, well, what about his legal issues? I'm like, listen, they settled. He bailed out almost $1 billion worth of player funds from Full Tilt that he did not have to do whatsoever, right? He was not convicted of a crime that put him in prison or whatever. It was essentially the same as a parking ticket. Got a parking ticket for transaction fees, a $25,000 fine, which was paid, no legal issues. The idea that he's not, you know, eligible for the Hall of Fame because of, you know, running an online gaming site it's just so ridiculous that the takes are so stupid that it boggles my mind. So I gave all my votes to Esai, and I do think there's a lot of other players on that list that deserve some recognition. But I just think that it's important because it's a long time coming. Like, I think Esai should have been in the Hall of Fame like a while ago, but I know that part of the reason was, you know, the case wasn't settled. His case is settled. It's all done. You know, he literally rescued the entire poker industry and grew it more than anybody else. Like, you can see guys like Moneymaker who, you know, grew, but the precipitous of that was, you know, Stars and Esai creating that, you know, option for someone like a Moneymaker to even exist. So, but I would definitely make some changes where we would make some clear delineations of what it requires in order to make it. And I don't know if it'll ever change, but, it is what it is.
Right. With sports, you know, NFL, NBA, golf, no matter what it is, golf, it applies a little bit less to, but most of the normal leagues, it does apply to. You have a career arc that lasts for 8, 10, maybe 15 years, during which you perform at the peak of your powers before retiring from that sport because you're simply unable to play. In poker, that will never happen. You can play until you literally die at the table. Like, and that has happened in the past. People just play because it's such a great game. And, you know, Doyle said it best. You don't get old because you stop playing. You, whatever that was. You get old because you stop playing. Everyone knows the saying. So my question is, how do we gauge Hall of Fame stuff for poker players? Do we look at a 10-year peak? Do we look, because, you know, take someone like Matisau. He was probably way ahead of the game for quite a long period of time. Currently, I wouldn't say that he is, you know, at the top. Maybe in Omaha 8 he still is, but in other games, clearly there's been so much studying going on that it's just impossible. So how do we gauge that in poker? What is the right way to assess someone's peak and success as it relates to the Poker Hall of Fame?
Yeah, right. So you're speaking to one specific criteria that says, you know, stood the test of time, right? Well, let's define what is the test of time. Like, Tom Dwan was at the peak of everything right now. And, you know, I don't know, he's not in the public eye as much. He's playing in private games or whatever. So has he stood the test of time? You know, it's hard to define that. So I had some ways. And I'm going to find this blog and I'm going to repost it because I think it was really, really, I mean, I think so because I wrote it, but it was well thought out. And for me, I would say, you know, I bought at least a decade of being at the top of the game. But I also think it's important to delineate now that poker's advanced. Like, you have to be exceptional at one specific part of the game. So you don't necessarily have to be great at everything, but you either were the top online player, you were one of the best in online, you were one of the best tournament players, you were a cash game killer. You have to be exceptional at something, not just like, oh, he was pretty good at all of it. No. You have to like really stick out, unless you are, you know, a Bobby's Room player who is well-rounded, you know, and plays all the games and all that kind of stuff. And because that was what the Hall of Fame was originally for. If you didn't play in Doyle Brunson's game in the big high stakes, like, you weren't even eligible, because I don't think of, you know, No Limit Hold'em as poker. It's one form of poker. And as you know, I know you love mixed games as well. So the mixed games guys always get preference from me, because I think, like, you know, that requires a diverse, you know, number of talents versus like specialists. So if you are a specialist in something, you need to be amazing at it to get my vote. You know, like a guy like Chris Moorman, for example, right? Chris Moorman, I don't know what his cash game prowess is like. He hasn't really crushed the live arena. This guy was like legendary online player, like legendary, you know? So for that, I would say, okay, he's got exceptional status because of he dominated one specific, you know, aspect of poker. So, you know, that's what it would require for me to put my vote on somebody like that.
Right. And this becomes more and more complicated as the entire, I guess, moneymaker generation will turn 40 in the next 10 years, depending on when they started. And then there's going to be so many people that hit that age requirement. And then we have to assess whether they're ready to be inducted and how long it will take. And has everyone gotten in from the boom era and prior? Like, I think that the Hall of Fame gets more complicated every year we move forward, right?
Yeah, for sure. And Moneymaker's a, you know, perfect case. Because listen, I love Moneymaker. We've been friends for, you know, since he won. You know, I've never had a bad thing to say about him. I didn't think he was Hall of Fame worthy personally. And he knows this. And, you know, and he would agree that, like, his career, you know, if you look at his stats or whatever, that's not Hall of Fame worthy. So right. Why was he inducted? He was inducted because of his effect, you know, his effect on the game, his influence on the game, which was real. But the question is, are we voting on him as a player, or are we voting him as, like, the builder, right? And in terms of building, outside of winning the tournament, you know, and being a great ambassador for the game, like, you know, specifically what things did he build in that regard, right? So if we look at him strictly as a player, not Hall of Fame worthy, I think he would agree, right? So then you're essentially saying he's a builder. So because as a player, it says nothing about your influence on the game. The player category, it's all about your play.
Right.
It also says, or if you contributed to the game in a positive way or as a builder in some case, right? So I guess, you know, as a builder, that's how you would classify Moneymaker as getting in. And again, I would say that someone like Esai Scheinberg, you know, takes the lead in that regard. But again, that's the thing. It's like everyone has a different view of what a Hall of Fame means. And I go puristic. I look at the actual rules of the vote and say, okay, based on this criteria, you know, would I vote for Moneymaker to go in? And I'd say, no, obviously he's famous. Obviously, if you just think of like Hall of most famous people, but that's not what a Hall of Fame represents. It represents, you know, excellence in a field. And I think, you know, he's like a perfect example of where it sort of is wishy-washy and unclear in terms of what we're voting for, right? So if Moneymaker went in, if there was, like I said, every 3 years, like a builder went in, put Moneymaker in the builder category. He would never belong on the player side, right? Because, you know, it's just, and again, he would be the first to readily admit that if you look at his career, it wasn't like, you know, Hall of Fame worthy so far. He could still crush, who knows, maybe he'll get all GTO on us.